Welcome back to SysTech. In the previous video, we configured FortiGate network and system settings. Today, I will demonstrate NAT, DNAT, and firewall policies. This video will help you set up a secure home office where you can perform business activities and allow remote employees to access your server. If you are interested in an in-depth understanding of cybersecurity and are planning to start your career in this field by becoming FCP, join me on Udemy to enroll in the FortiGate Administrator Training Labs. The link is in the description below. Let's discuss the scenario. You started a small business and want to set up a home office with a publicly accessible server. You also want remote workers to access your server without exposing your entire home office LAN. Additionally, you want to enable internet access for all home office workers. The solution? NAT, DNAT, and firewall policies. Let's have a look at our topology. NAT, 1.193.168.122.0/24. LAN, internal. 172.16.4.0/24. External. 202.175.75.0/24. What is NAT and DNAT? NAT, or Network Address Translation, translates private IPs to a public IP for outbound traffic. It is used when internal devices access external networks. DNAT, or Destination NAT, translates a public IP to a private IP for inbound traffic. It is used when external users access internal resources. NAT versus DNAT. Here's a comparison of NAT and DNAT. NAT is used for outbound traffic, translating private IPs to a public IP. DNAT is used for inbound traffic, translating a public IP to a private IP. NAT enables internet access, while DNAT allows remote access to internal servers. What is a firewall policy? A firewall policy is a set of rules that control traffic flow between networks. It allows or denies traffic based on security requirements and enforces security policies to protect internal networks. Let's go through the lab steps. We will access the FortiGate firewall, configure interfaces, set up source NAT and destination NAT, configure firewall policies, and finally test the configuration. Step 1, access FortiGate Firewall. First, open a web browser and navigate to the FortiGate management IP, such as https://172.16.4.2. Log in with your admin credentials. Step 2, configure source NAT, SNAT. Now, go to Policy and Objects, a firewall policy, and create a new policy. Set the incoming interface, LAN port. Outgoing interface, WAN port. Source, LAN, 193.168.1.0/24. Destination, to all. Schedule, always. Services, all. Action, accept. Enable NAT and use the outgoing interface address. Close to save the policy. Step 3, configure destination NAT, DNAT. Similarly, create another policy for destination NAT to allow the traffic coming from the external port to the LAN port. Go to Policy and Objects of Firewall Policy and create a new policy. Set the incoming interface to external port. Outgoing interface to LAN, port 2. Source port 3, external port. Destination, LAN port address. Leave schedule unchanged. Service, HTTP, if you are planning to expose a web server. I shall choose all for this demo. Action, accept. Enable NAT and forward traffic to the outgoing interface, the LAN interface. Press OK to save and close. Great job! We have created two firewall policies. One to allow internal devices to access external, the internet, and another. To allow external users to access the internal web server. In the case of this demo, all services are allowed, but it is not a good idea, rather, it is a security threat. Step 6, it is time to test the configuration. Now open the external and inter virtual machines. From the internal, LAN, client, ping an external IP like 8.8.8.8. Note down the ping result. From an external device, ping the server in your LAN. Open the firewall web interface. Check the amount of data transmitted. Check the logs of the firewall. Slide 14, summary. Let me summarize the tasks we performed. NAT translates IP addresses for secure communication, and firewall policies control traffic flow and enforce security. Together, they provide a robust network security solution. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe to SysTech for more tutorials.